On the northeast corner of Richmond and Wilson Mills Roads in Richmond Heights, Ohio, is the Richmond Town Square Mall. It was once considered the largest enclosed shopping mall in Ohio when it was built in 1966. At its peak, it had over 90 stores and served millions of shoppers until its eventual closure in 2021. Let's take a deep dive into the mall's history. Originally, in 1962, real estate developers Samuel Glazer and Vincent Murata wanted to build a $10 million regional shopping complex in Richmond Heights. Glazer and Murata were one of Ohio's leading shopping center developers during the late 1950s and mid-1960s. They owned and developed seven different shopping plazas and partly owned the Great Lakes Mall in Mentor, Ohio, with Edward J. DiBartolo, one of the top mall developers in the United States. It was called the Richmond Plaza and would have featured a 63-unit shopping center, arcade, business offices, and a 200-suite apartment development on 45 acres of land. In 1963, the apartment development was dropped in favor of building a buffer strip between the shopping center and houses on Edgewood Road. By 1964, Glazer and Murata had amassed an additional 25 acres of land, bringing their total to approximately 70 acres. However, the Richmond Plaza was never built as Glazer and Murata had bigger plans in mind. In February 1964, they announced their new plan to build a $42 million mall with more than 75 stores. A groundbreaking ceremony was held on July 25, 1964 for the 1 million square foot mall. Unfortunately, Glazer and Murata's progress was almost stagnant due to a major feat. The chosen site for the mall was on an apple orchard, and 27 homes surrounding the perimeter had to be relocated. This, combined with grading land and other preparations, had already cost them $1 million. The project grew so massive that in December 1964, they decided to sell the land and assets to Edward DiBartolo for an estimated $2 million. Construction officially began in May 1965, and on September 22, 1966, the Richmond Mall opened its doors. The mall was anchored by Sears, JCPenney, and a Lowe's movie theater. It also featured 72 other specialty shops like Radio Shack, a Woolworths discount department store, and a Winkleman's clothing store. The mall store capacity was later increased to 81 stores by 1975. Interestingly, there were even select special events throughout the year that offered ice skating and a petting zoo. In its first year of operation, the mall brought in nearly $54 million in sales and attracted over 300,000 customers. People from surrounding suburbs and beyond flocked to the new lavish mall. It caused other shopping plazas like Hilltop directly across from the mall and Eastgate in Mayfield Heights to lose a good portion of their customer base. However, in the 1970s, the Richmond Mall itself started facing fierce competition as the American shopping mall boom was in full swing. In 1977, Euclid Square Mall opened 4 miles to the north, and during the following year, Beechwood Place opened 3.5 miles to the south. The Richmond Mall was literally smack dab in the middle of these two other malls. Soon enough, the Richmond Mall's customer base began to slowly erode. As stores began closing or relocating, there were growing concerns of the mall closing during the 1980s, although ultimately nothing came of these rumors. The mall did receive a small boost in new tenants during the 1980s. In 1988, the Cuyahoga County Library opened a freestanding kiosk branch for Richmond Heights inside the mall. In 1989, Petiti Garden Center opened a store in the parking lot next to Sears. By the 1990s, the mall's interior became outdated and was in need of a serious remodel as its last upgrade occurred in 1983, although that upgrade wasn't much, mainly cosmetic improvements like new carpeting and more skylights. Stores began closing and leaving left and right as the mall's vacancy rate exceeded 40%. Another major blow happened when Woolworths closed all their department stores across the United States in 1997. Winkleman's also later closed in March 1998. The mall's owner, DiBartolo Corporation, did not have enough cash flow to upkeep their underperforming malls. In 1996, DiBartolo Corp. decided to merge with the Simon Property Group and began an estimated $100 million renovation of the Richmond Mall in the fall of 1997. Simon would later transfer ownership of the mall to their spin-off company, Washington Prime Group, in 2015. This renovation removed most of the interior characteristics the mall is known for, like its main concourse mezzanine and water fountains. In February 1998, the mall's name was changed to Richmond Town Square since it was rebranded as a community hub for residents. On November 5th, 1998, the mall reopened with another anchor, 15 new stores, and an additional 25,000 square foot extension that featured an 8-unit food court and restaurant. Their new anchor, Kaufman's, had moved from Euclid Square to Richmond Town Square and built a 2-story, 165,000 square foot department store. Other new additions featured a Barnes & Noble's bookstore and an all-new Lowe's theater complex that increased their viewing screens from 8 to 20. Richmond Town Square was seemingly reinvigorated as it had an 83% occupancy rate when renovations were fully completed in 2000. Well, this unfortunately only lasted about a decade as things have gone downhill ever since. In 2010, Barnes & Nobles began closing stores nationally. Their store at Richmond Town Square was one of those selected to close. On March 15, 2015, Kaufman's, which had been renamed to Macy's, closed their store, followed by Sears on March 26, 2017, and JCPenney on July 31, 2017. This effectively left Richmond Town Square anchorless. Washington Prime, heavily discouraged by this, put the mall into their non-core assets and sought to eventually sell it. On November 10, 2016, Cohan Retail Investment Group purchased Richmond Town Square for $7.25 million. Cohan Retail is an interesting company to say the least. They buy declining malls on the brink of closing and revitalize them as community hubs. On their website, it states, "We see the future of aging malls as a place for more than just shopping. Malls are evolving, and as time goes on, they are no longer just a tent to house box stores and chains, but are home to more local, small, and medium-sized businesses of all stripes." That has not been the case with Richmond Town Square, though. Although in recent years, two of the abandoned stores have been repurposed. In 2012, Planet Fitness moved into the former Barnes & Noble's building. In 2017, Deal Point Merrill, which is a commercial real estate brokerage and management industry company based out of Los Angeles, took interest in the former Macy's building. They ended up buying it in 2018 and converted it into a CubeSmart self-storage building. In February of this year, CubeSmart now operates under a new name called Life Storage. Deal Point also purchased the Sears building and properties surrounding it in 2018. They are proposing to turn the site into a mixed-use development. The $285 million project is called Bell Oaks Marketplace and is planned to feature luxury apartments, a hotel, and retail space. Deal Point's project scope later expanded into utilizing the entire 69.2 acres that Richmond Town Square encompasses. The project was supposed to have begun in late 2020, but that was delayed due to litigation between Cohan Retail and Deal Point over the sale of the entire mall. Cohan Retail also still owes over $700,000 in unpaid property taxes going back to 2017. Based on recent news articles from Cleveland.com and press releases from Deal Point, it looks like a deal will be finalized soon. As for Richmond Town Square, the mall finally closed its doors on May 16, 2021. There were only 8 tenants left operating. The mall structure is now in the process of being vacated in preparation for demolition this coming fall. Deal Point will, however, keep the Regal Cinemas, Life Storage, and Planet Fitness buildings standing. On June 5, 2021, Deal Point held an event in the former Sears parking lot where the community could meet the development team of Bell Oaks. It featured a video presentation and refreshments from East Coast Custard's food truck. I decided to check out the event and take in one last look at the mall. In conclusion, I for one will miss Richmond Town Square, as I'm sure hundreds and thousands of others who shopped and worked there over the past 55 years. Well, that is all I have for now. I want to thank everyone for watching this video. If you enjoyed it and want to see more, make sure you like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel.